Welcome to the next video on flat. In the previous video, we have seen about the block diagram of finite automaton. Analytically, we have represented the finite automata with five tuples. M is equal to Q sigma delta Q naught and F. We have seen definition of these individual tuples. Then we have seen how to represent M by transition diagram and transition table and how to get these five tuples. Also, we know the condition of acceptance of a string by the given DFA. We have to reach the final state after processing the entire string while starting with the initial state. In the last video, we have been left at this juncture for obtaining whether this string is going to be accepted or not. Now we will process this string starting with the initial state. So first symbol is B. Q naught upon reading B goes to Q1. So transition is like this. Again, next input symbol is B. Upon reading B, Q1 goes to Q0. Next input symbol is A. So Q0 after reading A goes to Q2. Next input symbol is B. So we have to see the transition function for Q2. Upon reading B, it goes to Q3. Next input symbol is A. Q3 upon reading A goes to Q1. And the last input symbol is B. Q1 upon reading B goes to Q0. This is the transition of states for the given string BBA, BAB. Final state is Q0 and we are reaching at this state after processing the symbols of the given string. So we are going to say that the given string is accepted by the automata. Now consider one transition diagram. So, in this transition diagram, we can easily find out that Q0 is the initial state, just arrow is placed at the Q0, and Q3 is the final state. We can also see that multiple transitions are defined for a particular input symbol A on Q0. Also, for B, it is not defined. Here, we can see that Q2 is defined for B transition to Q3, but for A it is not defined. Again, same is the case with Q3. So if the automaton is in state Q0 and the input symbol is A, then what will be the next state? So you can say that the next state can be Q naught or it can be Q1. Input symbol was A, and we see that upon reading A, Q naught can remain in Q naught or it can go to state Q1. So some moves of the machine cannot be determined uniquely by the input symbol and the present state. Such machines are called non-deterministic finite automata. In the previous video, we have talked about DFA, that is deterministic finite automata, where each move was uniquely defined. So again, we can define this with the help of five tuple: a non-deterministic finite automaton or NDFA or NFA is a five tuple Q sigma delta Q naught F, where Q is the finite non-empty set of states, sigma is the finite non-empty set of inputs, that is input alphabet, delta is a transition function mapping Q cross sigma into power set of Q. The set of all subsets of Q, Q naught is the initial state, and F is subset of Q is the set of final state. So again, we have defined NDFA with the help of these five tuples Q, sigma, delta, Q naught and F, set of states, input alphabet, transition function, initial state and set of final state. Now you can observe that difference between the deterministic and non-deterministic automata is only in delta. If you remember, for DFA, delta is defined as Q cross sigma mapping into Q, while in case of NDFA, delta is defined as Q cross sigma mapping into power set of Q. So you have to remember this. The basic difference between NFA and DFA is lying in delta. For deterministic automaton or DFA, the outcome is a state, that is an element of Q, while for NFA or NDFA, the outcome is a subset of state. So again, consider this automaton. We can process any string like previously. So just take an example. Suppose you have to process the string W is equal to AABAB. So we have to start from state Q naught. After reading A, it can go to Q naught or Q1. Again, the next input symbol is A, so the same thing can happen, Q naught and q1, while q1 upon reading A goes to q2. Next, input symbol is B. So this B is not defined. Here transition will not happen. Q1 B is defined and it remains on state Q1, while Q2 B it goes on Q3. Again, we have processed till the string the symbols AA, B. Next symbol is A. After reading A, Q1 goes to Q2, Q3. For Q3, A is not defined, so we are left with one path. Next symbol is B. Q2 B, you are reaching at Q3. So we can see that there are multiple paths for transition, but only one is reaching at the some state. Q3 being the final state, we can say that this path is leading to a final state. That is Q0, Q0, Q1, Q1, Q2, Q3. So formally, we can define a string W belonging to sigma star is accepted by NDFA M if delta star, that is extended transition function, Q0 W contains some final state. Meaning what? We can have multiple paths for the string, but at least one path must lead to the final state. That is, after processing this string, starting with the initial state, we must reach at the final state at some time. Now, there is a question for you all. Represent all 5 tuples for the given transition diagram and decide whether it is a DFA or NFA. The transition diagram is like this. This is the initial state. Q0, Q1, and Q2. One, zero, one, again, one, zero, zero, and one. Pause the video and come up with the answer. So you must have considered this diagram and decided whether this is a DFA or NFA. So just represent it like this. The 5 tuples are M is equal to Q sigma delta Q naught F. Here Q is the set of states, Q naught q1, q2. Sigma is the input alphabet consisting of 0 and 1. Q0 is the initial state. F is having one element, that is Q2, and delta is defined as, with the help of following table we can define it: state and input, input alphabet is 0 and 1, states are Q0, Q1 and Q2. If you remember, for initial state we have to mark an arrow and circle the final state. For Q0 reading 0, we are coming at Q1, while Q0 remains on Q0 and can go to Q1 upon reading 1. Q1 upon reading 0 goes to Q2, and Q1 upon reading 1 goes to Q0. Again, Q2 on reading 0 remains on Q2, and upon reading 1, Q2 goes to Q0. So we can see here that uniqueness is missing. So the given automaton is an NFA or NDFA, non-deterministic finite automaton. So now we have an idea about DFA and NDFA. Uniqueness is there in case of DFA, while uniqueness is missing in case of NDFA. The representation is done by these 5 tuples. All are same except this transition function in case of DFA. Delta is mapping Q cross sigma into Q, while if you remember, in case of NFA, delta is mapping Q cross sigma into power set of Q. Thank you.